And now, esteemed participants of Shinmen 12, I would like to introduce to you our keynote speaker, Mr. Yi Jogin, the Executive Director of UNESCO Center of Peace. We are beyond honored today to have him speak for us. Please give him a huge round of applause.
Okay, thank you. I would like, first of all, to invite Cindy and to come and speak with your colleagues. The two of you were just not there. You can hear. All right, one of them. Okay, I feel better like this. So before going to share some few words with you, I would like to present a proclamation that was written on the occasion. And as stated, my name is Yi Jogin, and I have a number of titles, but I think the most relevant here today is that I am the Executive Director of UNESCO Center for Peace Days in Washington, D.C., the United States. So, as you, the leadership of this event, gathered here, it was an honor for me to be here in Taiwan and to say a few words. So, this is a proclamation signed by me and delivered today, which is the opening session of the Xin Moon, right? Okay. I know I may not say the word exactly, but you know what I mean. So, the proclamation for the Xinjiang Modern United Nations, October 13, 2016. Whereas IBSH is hosting its 12th annual Modern United Nations this year, with focus on gender issues, and whereas this year's conference is hosted by the International Bilingual School at Xinjiang Science Park, Taiwan, and whereas the Xin Moon over the past 10 years has transcended the role as a simulation on model UN in Taiwan to morph into an exemplary model powered by IBSH students, teachers, and staff with their passion and love, and whereas you know, when I say IBSH, you know what I mean, right? The International Bilingual School. So whereas the International Bilingual School leadership and its student officers are proud to provide an international platform in which a group of students with an international minded can discuss and propose solutions to long-lasting crisis faced by the international community. And whereas UNESCO's mission is to contribute to peace and security by promoting collaboration among the nations through education, science, culture, and innovation. Its main goal remains to foster and maintain intellectual solidarity. And whereas UNESCO Center for Peace promotes the ideals of UNESCO, that ultimate goal is to achieve and maintain world peace. And whereas UNESCO Center for Peace supports projects an entity that promotes the ideal of peace, such as the 12th annual Xin Moon. Now, therefore, me, Yi Jogin, Executive Director of UNESCO Center for Peace, to hereby proclaim October 13, 2016 as Xinjiang Modern United Nations Days. Thank you. So, we have a copy. Okay. Thank you very much. I'd like to give a round of applause to the MC because she did a fantastic job. Thank you. I would like also to express my sincere thanks to Christina. Can I see that? Please stand up and receive a round of applause, please.
At a very early age,
family where the father was absent when I was growing up. Not because he wanted. My father was a political prisoner. And it was a very sensitive thing to talk about in Cameroon while I was growing up. Because, yes, a lot of people were in jail for things that were obvious. Like, they were stealing something, they were beating something, they committed a crime, and everybody could talk about it. But when it came to my father, you know, nobody wanted to say anything. So it was frustrating for me. Because, it's like, what's going on? You know, I did. So I couldn't get that. And when he came, eventually came out of prison, and the reason he went to prison is because he was actually the first mayor of a small town. When France was colonizing Cameroon, do you know what they colonizing? Colonization, yes. Colonizing Cameroon had to leave, they supposed to be an independence. But there were a group of people that actually wanted independence to mean what it said. So we were independent, so we had to be responsible for our future. But unfortunately, France, that was running the country, had no idea. They didn't want to have a real independence. So they wanted to put in some puppets, people that would be there as a facade, that they would keep taking the resources of the country on the back. So my father wanted a real independence. As a result, he had to pay the ultimate price. So when he eventually came out of jail, take a look at some of the people that he said made this world a better place. I studied Mahatma Gandhi. How many know about Mahatma Gandhi? Okay, yeah. Dr. King. Okay. Nelson Mandela. Che Guevara. Okay. So here are some few names where my father specifically asked me to go and study and learn if I wanted something that other children don't suffer what I suffer. I had to learn about these people because they are those who provide some guidance. And as I read and learn about all these things, I kept something, one thing keep coming up, the sense of purpose. Can someone tell me what the meaning of purpose, the purpose, a student? What is the purpose? I would like a brave one. What is the purpose? Okay, what's the purpose?
To have a goal in life.
Okay, give me a round of applause, please. If nothing else today, when I leave here, in a couple of days, I want to remember that word. Because that word is what helped me be the best that I am here today. Having a sense of purpose. We all have a very short life. For some, it could be 100 years. For some, it could be 30 years, 40, whatever it is, a very short life. And think about this. We are going to live someday, whether we like it or not. And why are we here? This is my fundamental question. Why are we down here? Is it to get as many million, billion dollars as we want? Then we're going to leave and we're going to leave them behind. Having a purpose, having a meaning to your life. I look at so many people in your life, and I have to say they are successful, very successful. Why? Because they have a big accounting bank. But what moves me the most is those who are living what they call a meaningful life. I want to say have meaningful life. Mahatma Gandhi had what we call a meaningful life. When he was dying, the things he would say, this is mine. This belongs to me was less than $5. He had nothing. But yes, as soon as someone had a meaningful life. So when you have a sense of purpose, what am I doing down here? Our Creator, it doesn't matter how you call him, he sent us here for something. When I leave this earth, why? How do I want to be remembered? Okay? So when you think like that, and start making a difference between what is meaningful and what is successful, then you start showing that's, you know, my passion. So I was lucky enough that my father pushed me that direction. And as he did that, you know, that, and I started studying these people and learning about them, I realized that to be successful, that I have to have a meaningful life. And by having a meaningful life, meaning that doing things to enhance, you know, that enhance to make it better, the life of other human beings. And I think when you do that, you go home, you sleep, and you're happy. A number of years ago, I was invited to go to Egypt by a young girl. She was about 15, 16 years old. And she had attended my summer camp. I'll come play in a moment. So here am I going to Egypt. She planned my whole trip. A young girl. And when we got there, the place where she couldn't get to, she planned a meeting with her parents because some places ladies were not allowed to attend. You know, she'll go with me, she'll wait for me outside. I go in because as a girl, she went there. I'll come back with a resolution. That was a young girl. And when those kind of things happen to you, you know, you see this young woman that attended her camp, she goes there and she brings some leadership, and you are proud because you know that you are helping her fulfill her. The topic of today, gender equality, is something that's very, very important. And this is even more important for me when I was born, like I say, in Africa. When I saw my mom working on average 15 hours a day, so that we could have something to eat on the table. And as we step into the shoes of an ambassador, representing a country, sometimes a country you don't know, you are given the opportunity to travel. Because when you are taking those decisions today, you're not making based on you as a person. You have to step into the shoes of someone, read about that country, see what they think on this issue, and make those decisions. What are some of the major issues the world is facing right now? I'm engaging. What are some of the major issues that the world is facing? The refugee crisis. We have an unprecedented number of people that have no home. They have to leave their homes. When you look at that number, what the percentage of women in those who are suffering is very high, right? Even in my country, yes, I was born in Cameroon, but now I am an American. In my country, the United States, listed by many as a model for the same job, a woman and a man, you know, a woman is still having about 70%, 70% of what a man is having for the same job. Okay? And we sometimes see ourselves as a model. Is that model?
No.
Question mark. So, as you debate these things, you have to really look at the whole. What is the whole? This is not just a fun exercise. We've done research. Now, we are debating another person. And why? Because we are trying to make the world a better place. Why? Well, the United Nations founded 7 years ago. And one of the criticisms of the United Nations is that we have some diplomats sitting in those tower, you know, and totally disconnected to the reality. Some of them have no clue about the reality. And what we are doing is so important because before you get to that level, you know the reality. And like I said earlier today, whether we like it, one day or another, we are going to leave. And you'll be ready for that leadership. And when you get to that issue, you are going to remember one another. You are going to remember when you were here at this moment, how you were able to connect with another person. That's why I thank the school for providing the platform, this platform. And my commitment, Christine, to you is that I hope, along with other people, that next year, you are not going to have only people from Taiwan, but hopefully a number of people. I will personally try to bring some people here from Africa, from Europe, from the United States, because that's how we are going to plan the future of what we see. So, gender equality is one of the major issues we are facing as well, everywhere around the world. In Africa, for instance, men in general bring home the income. It's also true in India. But guess what? In many families, that income end up in bars, in other places. And we found Gorilla is not a laureate from Bangladesh, Imus, the famous who received his Nobel. He was an economist, but received his Nobel laureate for doing some economic work. And we went, how is that possible? His jury was an economist. But he realized that giving small loans, specifically to young to women, had an impact that was unthinkable around him. Because when you women, whether you like it or not, care about their families more than what men do. That's just the reality. I know some people will, you know, try to say that, but that's reality. And that's what you see that around the world. So, when we work towards bridging that gap and making men and women equal, what we are doing, we are actually planting the seed of peace. Because that mom, when they get up, they're thinking about the son, they're thinking about the family, they're thinking about many other things. And that's why I think the topic that we picked this year is very, very important. Again, we are going to have a life of hopefully live to be 100, maybe a little more. But what matters in this life is not the length, it's what you use your life to do. And I thank you for providing the word, because I'm not coming here to share with you the things going on. I'm here to share my life. And that's why I open a little bit so that you see how I got by, why and how I got by, and get you to start thinking about what I think is meaningful. The role you are playing is very, very important. When we look at this band, how many people were needed to get this band playing that beautiful music? How many people did you see involved in us receiving, enjoying that music? How many people did you see? The team that played that music, that one we enjoy. How many people were there? How many people helped us? Okay. If I was to say two people on the stage, please clap for them. Three people were on the stage. Didn't say three people. Yes, we had three on the stage, but before that we have three that came out and everybody had a role to play. And sometimes you need to forget about those, because without those three that came and each one playing a role, we never can enjoy the music. And that's how the world is all about. So I'm pointing that to tell you that, you know, every one of us has a role to play. God gave us different skills. The skill I have, you may not have it. The skill you have, I may not have it. And guess what? We have to lead the world, right? So somehow, I have to use my skill to your advantage, and have your skill to my advantage. And that's how you're going to be happy and going to be happy. And the other thing that I want to say before is that, yes, I run the Center for Peace. So I see a lot about people fighting, disagreement and things like that. And the one thing that I realize is that sometimes people fight because they think they are right. And I share this with your principal people. Just being right doesn't make it right. Okay? Being right is not sufficient in life. Because yes, I have all the facts on my hand, so what? The most important, when you go through this exercise, is to find the opportunity, find the means, and that's where you need to be a diplomat. Find the means to get the other person to stand where you stand. stand and look at the same thing you are looking at exactly at the same time. That, if you are able to do that, you have a success life, because nobody is stupid. Nobody just wants to come in and fight. Sometimes because you are looking from something from one angle and the other person. I just want a very simple example. This book, okay, this is handle. I will put a small example saying, you from this angle, how is the book look like? They are going to see what you read here, and they said, this person on this side, I want to do something totally different. Let's we all leave today and say, and couple down the road, couple of weeks, and say, okay, describe the handle that you had in hand. We are going to say, you saw this one written here, all the things you saw here. This side is going to see, this handle had these flowers, blue flowers, and this. They're not talking about written on it. And they say, are we talking about the same handle that you had? They say, no. No, I saw it in my eyes, so we are stupid, we didn't see the same thing. And then, before we realize, we are all talking about the same thing, even though we are describing different things, and then we start war, start fighting about that. But if at some point you can come from there and look at from the same angle, and you are looking at the same thing, then you are more like, oh, okay, by the way, we are talking about the same book. On one side, it was the other side. So, your job as you go into the modeling is exactly that. Even when you think someone is wrong, just think about this. Where is it looking at this from? And then hopefully you are going to bring the other person to look at what you are from the same angle, from the same side, see what you are seeing. And then by so doing, actually you are a stronger person. And the last thing I want to say is that we all have the opportunity to do something in our life. When I came through this, I came up with an idea with Mr. Seth and others to create what we call the International Modeling United Nations Summer Program. It's a two-week program where we bring bright minds like yours near Washington, D.C. for 2 weeks. When you come here, you're full of energy, you work hard and things like that. By the third day, you have to leave. But we have the possibility for people to come and for 2 weeks in Washington, D.C. And during that time, of course, we can model the United Nations. We also have the opportunity to come, dance, music, you know, fun, field trip, and also we also take you to the United Nations for a day. We meet ambassador, we meet the Security Council and other things. And this is my was okay, I would like to do something to provide a platform just like you're providing here where people, young people from around the world are going to start building the leadership that's needed, the partnership that's needed to create a brighter future. So hopefully, to all the Modern UN directors that are here, Mr. Seth Robert and Ms. Robert also, they actually are integral part of our Model International Model United Nations, and they will provide more information. But I'm also happy to come back again in Taiwan next time if needs be to talk about this and other things. So on that, I would like to thank you for the opportunity for allowing me to be part of this wonderful event, and I'm looking really forward to seeing you performing, to see you exercise leadership, and hopefully we are going to come out here with some decisions that we present to the real delegate at the United Nations in New York. Thank you very much.